Who is this strange beast, this anaconda?
Jennifer Lopez. Ice Cube. Eric Stoltz. Jonathan Hyde. Kari Wuer. Owen Wilson. Vincent Castellanos. And John Voight. In Columbia Pictures, Anaconda.
All right, everybody. Double check your gear. Make sure it's all on board. Pray you didn't forget your bug spray.
I play a documentary film director who goes out to the Amazon.
Not every day my homegirl from SC get to direct her own documentary.
To film a tribe called the Shirishama.
Dr. Stephen Kale, the resident anthropologist in the expedition.
Damn, Kale, you look like a little low-budget-ass Jacques Cousteau there.
Joignez-moi avec mon équipe dans les aventures citons.
She hires me as the cameraman, you know, so, you know, I'm just really there to just shoot the documentary.
In search of the elusive people of the mist, the Shirishama tribe.
They find this man whose boat supposedly is in trouble.
What bring you on board?
Never pick up hitchhikers.
Yep, do not pick up strangers.
His name is Paul Saron.
He's a snake poacher.
I trap snakes for a living.
And I'm sure you're very good at it. I locate tribes for a living, and I'm very good at that.
He's set up to be a classic villain.
What the hell is this?
Anaconda skin.
It's snakes out there this big? So he sabotaged the trip and get us to go the wrong way for us, but the right way for him to catch a snake.
Walt Conti and the craftsmen at Edge Innovations created the 25
Walt
and 40-foot animatronic
well
snakes used in Anaconda.
Ability to create real creatures, creatures that look like they look like in life.
It looks so real, and it moves. The way they have it, it moves so real that you get fooled.
No matter how familiar you are with the process, how much you have that snake in your mind, when you encounter the reality of that beautiful animatronic creature, it was quite an impression.
Walt did the animatronic side of it, and then we did the visual effects side of it, which would be computer generated. At Sony Pictures Image Works, his snake was somewhat stationary because it's very heavy and very powerful. So when it came to full body motion and something very dangerous and elaborate interaction between the characters and the snake, then it would come back to us. And how we would do that is we would go and work with the stunt coordinator, Webster Winery, on this. And we would define what should be done. And then he would work out special rigs for that.
In the case of our movie, they were just such perfectionists about those kind of shots. I just think that they look magnificent.
Snakes don't eat people.
Oh, they don't? Anacondas are a perfect killing machine.
For my character, she's just kind of a little suspicious of him from the beginning.
No cause for panic.
I'm not panicking. I'm just looking at this wall that's blocking our way down this river that you know.
My character kind of looks up to him, and so he sort of like starts to kind of take me under his wing. Saron and I go on this little raft to go like dynamite this dam. In that process, I think we disturb the
fate takes over, and we end up with a much greater adventure than
half the film
any
was shot on location on the
planned
Amazon
or packed for.
The remainder was shot at the transformed Los Angeles Arboretum.
Back on the boat.
Almost as a reflex, you talk about a snake, you see a snake, and there's something in you that very deeply tenses up.
Matteo, you have control of this vessel!
Matteo's the captain of the boat. Can we trust Matteo? I don't know, you have to see for yourself.
Looks like I'm gonna have to cut us loose.
Maybe better I do it. This river can kill you in a thousand ways.
I'm getting the hell back to L.A.
I think we have such a wonderful cast. It's just so diverse and interesting.
I play a sort of English wanker.
You, stir this in my room, will you?
Excuse me? I'm not the bellhop, I'm the production manager.
Denise probably believes more than anybody else that this is just going to be, you know, a really great bonding experience for everybody. And it is, only in a really tragic way.
What struck us about this first was the material, was the potential to scare people.
I just love the whole idea of this movie.
There's nothing that can replace this film.
Faster, come on!
Anaconda.
You're gonna get us all killed!
When you can't breathe, you can't scream.
When he turns around, he starts going, and all of a sudden, there's another splash, and then you see the snake, and you guys, so you never make it alone to the boat. Just a few feet away from her, you see the snake, and then you start going. But I'm not gonna go as far as that today.
All you're gonna do is hear the splash, we turn around.
Hear the splash, turn around, and maybe you start going, because I need to tie that with the snake on the deck.
Okay.
Yeah, that's one thing that happened.
Mm-hmm. So somebody's driving, and all of a sudden, the snake shows up there.
It comes down like that. Uh-huh. Yeah, that's great.
Eye to eye.
Well, you know, the one thing I noticed downstairs that I had never really noticed because I hadn't seen the immensity of it, the way you can get down behind it, is it's a very scary shot to be back here if all of the snake's sensors are up here and he's missed you. And you just see it all going away because it's so huge, you know, it's so incredibly big.
Right? Also, yeah. I want a more, like, sneaky.
And action. Keep on rolling.
Stop!
Good. Excellent.
Richard. Good.
Let's shoot it. Good job. That's the picture. Ready, Nick?
Yeah.
Rolling. Roll A, B cameras.
Speed A.
Speed. That's speed, Sochi. And roll this division. Walt tilt up a little. Hearing. Keep rolling.
Keep rolling. Keep rolling.
21 to cut. And a cut. That's a cut.
B mark.
Light it.
See, that was all us.
Run! If you come face to face with an anaconda, run. I'll say that again. If you come face to face with an anaconda, run. The snakes, I mean, of course I'm a little ick about them, but, you know, it's okay. You know, I just don't want them to get too close to me. You know, I don't want anybody biting me because I'm going to have to bite them back. You know. My character's name is Terry Flores. It was originally Terry Porter, but I got the role. So we named her Flores, and I play a documentary film director who goes down to the Amazon to film a tribe called the Shirishama to try and capture them on film. They've never been captured on film before, and we get down there, we rent a boat, and we go out with my crew, which includes Ice Cube and Eric Stoltz and Owen Wilson, and we pick up this weird guy named John Voight. And he's a poacher, and we kind of get into a little bit of trouble along the way, and he tries to help us out. Yeah, the snake is incredible. So it's an incredible creature that they've created. It's scary. It's scary being in the frame with it. It's scary being in the scene with it because its eyes move, its tongue, you know, it looks so real, and it moves. The way they have it, it moves so real that you get fooled. And sometimes it moves by itself. Can you believe that? And you're like, it is alive! It can kill me!
I play a guy named Danny Rich, who's he's a cameraman, very good cameraman, and his friend Terry, who is the lead actress, played by Jennifer Lopez, she basically gets, you know, we were college buddies, so she this is her directorial debut, doing a documentary on the Shirashama. She hires me as the cameraman, you know, so, you know, I'm just really there to just shoot the documentary, and then we get caught up in all this snake drama. You know, we start up the river, and we run into this stranded boat. You know, the river's like 4 miles wide, so if you're stranded, you're stranded. So we pick the guy up, and he's Sarone. He's a snake poacher. So he sabotaged the trip and get us to go the wrong way for us, but the right way for him to catch a snake. And he's trying to catch a 45-foot anaconda to sell. And that's how we get caught up into all this drama. Well, I don't like poisonous snakes. And it's really hard to determine sometimes which ones are poisonous, which ones are cool. The ones that just, you know, the constricting snakes, which an anaconda is, it's cool. Unless, of course, it gets around you. But, you know, I'll touch it. I hate snakes, really, to be honest. Man, I've never seen nothing like it. I mean, this, we had a power surge. And for a minute, they didn't have control of this snake. And you have this thing that's like 1,800 pounds on board, moving like a real snake. And they have no control. You know, that's when... You know, reality and real life kind of like merges, you know. So this snake is the best animatronic thing I've ever seen in my life.
I am Dr. Stephen Kale, the resident anthropologist and the head of this ragged expedition. It's all my fault. I've hired everybody to make a documentary about a group of legendary, unacculturated Indians up the Amazon, and we set out to make this documentary, and fate takes over, and we end up with a much greater adventure than any of us had planned or packed for. I tell you, I think the snake that they've made for this film is... Computer snakes look more real and more terrifying than the real ones, which is strange but true. It's a big snake movie. Jennifer Lopez wrestles a giant snake. Come on, I'd be the first in line to see this movie.
But also they're a symbol, aren't they, for us? And they're a symbol of arrogance in the Garden of Eden. The snake was the arrogant one that said, "No, do it. What the hell? Hell with God, you know?" And he's responsible for many things about the human condition, apparently. So it's probably a portrait that needs being painted, you know. Who is this strange beast, this anaconda? Well, he's, when this picture is assembled, and of course we're right in the middle of shooting, one hopes that he will become very memorable in the aspect of his danger, of his kind of insanity, and because of that, there's a humor about the character. He's set up to be a classic villain. So hopefully I can embody that character to the satisfaction of the audience, you know. But it's fun character. Some of the stuff with the snake has got to be anticipated much in advance. So a lot of work has to go into this stuff, and the guys who are doing it quite well here. I mean, it's going to be quite spectacular.
I play the sweet, kind, animal-loving, giving, smart Denise. She's a very sensitive character. I think she embodies the sensitivity of the American audience in this piece. She's a good kid. And it's all about this legend and how these giant snakes are guardians for this tribe. And they're intruding into a tribe that is not westernized, has their own culture. And basically the gods are looking down on this little crew and saying, ah, you should leave these people alone. So it's a big lesson we're learning. And as you can see, by the way, I look right now, I'm in my final stages of life. I might live, I might not. She's really kind of in tune with the beauty of her surroundings, and you know, there's a line in the film that says something to the effect of, the jungle is not a laboratory, okay? You can't go down there to experiment. It's the real thing. So the crew finds out that it is the real thing, and she takes it really hard. It's not as, you know, exotic and romantic as she once believed.
To be prey? No one likes to be prey. I mean, but it happens so quickly, I don't have a lot of time to reflect on being prey. It's like one minute I'm, you know, walking along the edge of the boat, the next minute the snake has attacked me. So it's like, boom, I'm prey. Is that how I want to go? My big snake? You know what? I guess there are worse ways to go. When we blow up the dam, Saron and I go on this little raft to go dynamite this dam. We just blow it to hell. And in that process, I think we disturb the ecological balance or something, and the snakes are really pissed off and everything, and that's when things start to turn. Extremely realistic. Very realistic. Have you guys seen that snake working? That thing? Oh man, that thing's unbelievable. It's this huge snake. And in fact, I hear that they have two of them. Do they have a second snake? They have a bigger one. They have a bigger snake. And I've only seen the one that's, I don't know how big, but that one's terrifying. So I'm scared to see the other one. More snakes around. So that created, you didn't have to act so much because you were kind of terrified. You were kind of scared.
I play a sort of English wanker called Warren Westridge, who's a sort of pompous sort of, he's described as a pompous arsehole by one of the other members of the crew for good reasons. I don't care for them particularly. I'm not immediately sort of I don't like to go and pick them up. I don't know. I suppose I'm afraid of them. I'd have to say that because I think I sort of am. I'm in awe of them certainly. I don't think they're wicked. Some people think, you know, a snake is a sort of bad symbol in most respects. Well, I mean, it should thrill and disgust at the same time. I don't know what sort of button you press to get that particular cocktail, but I would say that would be more or less it.
It's a very scary feeling, you know. It's very intense to experience lack of control, and it's very, very scary to feel being watched, and to sense that sense of losing your mortality just for that moment, right before it happens. It's a very, look, I get goose pimples. It's a very, very scary thing. I play Mateo. Mateo's the captain of the boat. You want me to tell you about Mateo? Yeah, you don't like those one-word answers?
Well, you know, short and brief, sound bites are just great.
Boom! No, Mateo is basically a guy who loves booze, loves women, and loves snakes. Oh, by a storm. This movie is just gonna go wild, man. It's got all the elements for like a big, huge, you know, go crazy kind of film. I have seen it and I play with it a little bit outside of the water, and as an actor, it's like a dream come true because I cannot tell that it's not a real snake. It is so incredible, you know, and it's moves and the eyes and the mouth. It's like it's there.
When they're already traveling is when they find this man whose boat supposedly is in trouble. So they bring him aboard out of goodwill. He's a man abandoned in the middle of the jungle. This is the Saron character played by John Boyd. And he's a man of the jungle. He tells them that he's seen, that he knows where they can find the Shirishama tribe. And they say maybe it's a great opportunity to get help from this guy. I don't think they ever feel comfortable about his presence. He's kind of a strange, wild, mysterious character. But all the same, they think that he could be useful. By the way, when I refer to gigantic, I'm not saying something that belongs to fantasy land. We're dealing with an anaconda that is 40 feet. The anaconda that we have in the picture is 40 feet. And there's chronicles in reality of people that have encountered anacondas that are bigger than that. You know, before the film, one of the most scary things is when you see a real anaconda attacking the victim. You know, they eat different types of mammals, and they have the prey there, they look at it, and all of a sudden they launch, you know, with extreme violence, and then they wrap around the victim, like embracing, you know, embracing in a very powerful way. And the victim, in about 15 seconds, faints out of the pressure, because the pressure that is putting the anaconda is putting pressure on the heart. It's very interesting how, almost as a reflex, you talk about a snake, you see a snake, and there's something in you that very deeply tenses up. And I guess that comes from, like, you know, from even past stages of humankind. I think that, as I say, one way or another, people are fascinated by snakes, and even if we hate them, you know, we're gonna have this little perverse curiosity to try to see that on the screen. I had seen part of the process, but all of a sudden I went into the tent where they had finished building the snake, and all of a sudden to see that the snake really had this sense, all this texture that gave it such a reality, all this kind of life of its own, and in those proportions, in that sort of gigantic proportions, to see that moving in front of you, no matter how familiar you are with the process, how much you have that snake in your mind, when you encounter the reality of that beautiful animatronic creature, it was quite an impression.
Have an exciting action adventure film at the same time. So we went on the faith of what the potential for this movie could be first. Secondly, to back it up, really felt that we needed to find the right creature creator to be able to pull it off. And that was an unknown until we started actually going through that process.
The animatronic snake had two limitations. One was not being able to move from point A to point B across the floor, in which case the complete slithering across the floor needed to be done with computer graphics. The other one was because of the power and speed which we needed from the animatronic snake to make it work very effectively, when it was really wrapping and enclosing our actors, we would not put them in that position. Because of computer graphics, we can do so much more than you've ever been able to do before. So you're opening up your imagination to really just fly and go where it wants to go.
I think we have such a wonderful cast. It's just so diverse and interesting. I love that about it. And Ice Cube, of course, is going to bring a lot to this movie. Well, I'm one of those kind of people that really love horror films and thrillers and action-adventure. That's the kind of movie I really love. And I have real commercial taste, which I'm very grateful for. But I just love the whole idea of this movie. And I saw the potential of it being a big, like, Jaws-type movie or Aliens. And just from the very beginning, I just knew that this would be a winner. And I hope I'm right. Yes, I mean, almost everybody I talk to say, oh, I can't go see that movie. I'm just terrified of snakes. And I say, well, how do you feel about sharks? Oh, the same thing. You know, well, did you see Jaws? Oh, yeah. You know, so I think people really like to be, in some ways, afraid as long as they're safe in their little seat with popcorn. And but I think everybody likes that thrill of being afraid, as long as they know they're safe.